RSLogix 5000. Is it a PLC or a PAC? An introduction to the industrial computer called a PAC using a ControlLogix PAC and RSLogix 5000 software as an example. So, what is a PAC? First a tip, master the PLC before learning the PAC. PAC stands for Programmable Automation Controller, an industrial computer that emulates a PLC, motion control, and much more. RSLogix 5000 is the software required to work with Rockwell's brand of PACs. A PLC compared to a PAC is like a calculator compared to a computer. Literally, as both a calculator and a PLC have a single scan cycle and can run just on a microprocessor, where, as a computer and a PAC, require multiple full processors so they can multitask. A PLC runs a single task, scan cycle, in a loop, like a wheel on a bicycle. A PAC is like a car in comparison, allowing multitasking and multiple functionalities. A PAC can take the place of multiple PLCs. A PLC typically has 1 to 2 programming languages. A PAC, 4 to 5. A PLC is restricted to polling a network and backplane in between scan cycles. With a PAC, every module is a device on the Ethernet network. A PAC has additional differences to the PLC too, like motion control, tags, firmware, etc. There are many more differences, some of which are listed here. A PLC can only have one processor module in the first slot. A PAC can have multiple modules in any slot, as they are just Ethernet devices on a network. When a PAC is just being used to replace a PLC, ladder logic is still the common programming language. But sometimes, the machine designer is using a COBOL-like computer programming language instead. It is called structured text. The PAC also has much greater memory and processing power. Thus, it can handle multiple PLC programs and many more input-outputs, as well as simultaneously communicating on multiple networks. The following are excerpts from the introduction section of the CLX Trainer, a Coldwater RSLogix 5000 training certificate course software.
Capable of being programmed using 4 languages. They are traditional ladder logic programming, sequential function chart programming, structured text programming, and function block diagram programming. Multitasking multidiscipline. This feature allows the controller to handle up to 32 tasks, one continuous and up to 31 periodic or simply 32 periodic. A task provides priority and scheduling information for a set of one or more programs that are executed based on a specific set of criteria. These tasks operate interrupts so that the controller will suspend execution of the current task to perform the task being called. Each individual task can schedule up to 32 programs. Each one of these programs can have their own data and logic. The producer-consumer network model is used by the ControlLogix system. In this type of network, the producer places a connection ID at the beginning of the data packet. The packet or message is then multicast, and each module screens the ID to determine if it needs the data. If it does, then that module becomes the consumer. This allows the programmer to have one or many modules to listen for and consume data with its specific connection ID, while discarding or ignoring all others. Use of this type of networking model allows individual modules to produce data without having been pulled by a controller first. Data will be multicast based on either a time interval or a change of state. The modules for ControlLogix systems, including controllers, communications, and motion modules, are flash upgradable. This feature enables the user to perform flash memory upgrades to the firmware version of any module. The ControlLogix system can also function as a communications gateway. It can contain the modules needed to communicate with other networks, such as Remote I/O, Ethernet IP, Data Highway Plus, and ControlNet. This feature allows communications with existing networks so that messages may be sent to and from the other networks.